Okay, we're going to go through and check a bunch of sets that I picked up, rescues, for possible resurrection. This is a Ward's Airline. Volume pot's broken off. I don't know if I did that on my watch. This one was buried in mud. Let's check the tube. Look at the bottom of this thing. Ugh. It almost looks like GE. It's all tube, rusted, all rusted as rusted could get. It's all tube. It's, God, look at the rust. Even the purity rings are rusty. Man, you would have to be really desperate to want to resurrect this thing. It's weird how this is behaving exactly like that Zenith. Get the other CRT tester and give them a little love tap. So with this one, I'm getting similar results. That's green, that's green, that's blue, that's red. So at this one, we can come over here and we can give the booty a little pinch and see what happens. And I think when you do this rejuvenate, it kind of heats the voltage up a little bit there on the filaments. So what I'll do is I'll let it warm up a second and then I'll push the lightning button and we'll see which we're on green. So that would be that gun right there. Here we go. Nothing. Let's do blue. Blue is on top usually. Yeah, there's a little flash. Okay, so let's go back to this. Now it'll drop because the filaments are cooling back down, but on color CRTs, if the guns don't track the same and if they're not well into the green zone, you're going to get weird color bleeding and saturation of the cathodes, and it's just not going to ever produce a good color picture. And rejuvenating was very temporary. It was really just to get the customer to shut up until you could order a new CRT or get them into a new TV. Well, that woke them all up. Going back to this one, look at that. The rejuvenation sure did wake it up, but again, it's only temporary. So after that, this CRT is testing okay, but you know, like I say, it's temporary. It's not gonna... it's not going to last forever. So let's take a look at this for a second, because At one time, these were everywhere, and now they're almost impossible to find. So it's a series string. It's all compactron tubes, which are these big high number of pins. I don't know what they are, 12 or 15 pins. So it's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 compactrons, and then we got our damper and our horizontal output. Filter cap is back there. Couple filter caps. Convergence, rust assembly. You see, we got some water streakage here. It's just cool to look at these because I remember when these were everywhere and now they just don't exist. Maybe one day. It's not a whole lot of risk in turning this on, is there? Ooh. Except a power switch that doesn't work. But I see we have glowing. Come on. There we go. Kind of quiet. Well, DOA. Here is specimen number two. Bradford. Bradford color. Let's take a look at that right there, their logo. It's a fine, fine specimen. So well preserved. Okay, well, this is a hybrid set. Matsushita, I believe. Panasonic. And unfortunately, we have this right here. Have a look here. It's got a solid state IF back there in the back. And yeah, this is unfortunate. Yep. End of the line. What do we got there? A focus resistor. Well, it's good I got to see a Bradford because this is one of those sets that you see in the Sams and you're like, I hope I get to see one of those in real life. And it's just a Panasonic rebadge. Look at how they have the filter caps over here. And what's sad is this has the original horizontal output tube in it. I bet the CRT in this was good. I bet it was super strong. All the original tubes in it. You see there, it does have some hours. By the way, that's discolored from the heat. Okay, here's the next one. And I don't even know who makes it, but look at these scratches in the CRT. This is junk. No name on this at all, no nameplate. Okay, let's see what this is. This is this could be one of those RCA Taiwan knockoffs. They must have made a gazillion of these tabletop black and whites. And tube tabletop black and whites, and I mean a gazillion. I'd like to see the numbers sold in this country. I bet it was a billion, maybe? Half a billion? Think of how many of them there are in landfills. And it's very possible that if this is an import, this is not the right adapter for this. Okay, this is a 20 WP4 or a 500 BAB4. It's 500 millimeter. And looked it up in the book here. It's glowing. And this sucker is dead. Let's open up a party on this sucker. Let's go up to let's go up to 8 volts. Screaming nice and loud now. Nobody home. You know, there's a condition where the cathode weld breaks, where the little wire that goes from the pin to the cathode breaks off. And that causes this. And sometimes you can weld them with this machine if you can get them to, if you can bump them and get them to hit, but I'm not even getting that on this one. Okay, here's the next candidate. This is an Emerson. And got kind of an interesting back. Maybe you should just plug it in and turn it on and not even take it apart. What the hell, why not? The last two have had dud CRTs, might as well spark this one up. Okay, here we go, contact. Is this a timer? No channel selector knob at all. Oh, it's broken off. But how do you turn it on? Vertical hold, contrast brightness. Nope, nobody home. Let's open it. A lot of people always referred to Emerson as junk of the time. And it's kind of interesting how this is a wraparound circuit board. It's got a power transformer, though. It's a power transformer set. And 5U4 right there. Can see somebody has replaced the horizontal phase detector diode. They just cut it off the top and tacked a new one on. Yeah, it's glowing. Geez, is that all you're gonna give me? I'm at 6.3 volts. We'll go up a little bit higher with that. I'll let this sit for a minute. Okay, it's creeping up after a long time. Guess we could give it a little booty pinch and see what it does. I hate to do this, but it went down. It's questionable. Is it worth resurrecting? I don't know. It would be simply just time spent to make a video so that people could watch a video of a TV that produced a blurry, inverted, cloudy image. This is probably the reason right here why. This is probably the reason right here why it won't power up. Okay, here's the next one. This is a little Sears solid state. This is a George Jetson Amos and Andy certified chic 60s style. Forget all of the buzzwords they've attached to that. Now this is kind of cool. Japanese made germanium. Doesn't look like there's much to it. Oh, the whole bottom is a big board. Made by Toshiba, I think. That's who made these. Probably needs every cap changed. I probably could check this if I knew the number. I'm not going to waste my time if I ever get motivated to try and see it work. These are not real practical. I mean, it's not something you would hook up to the cable box and watch. So we'll go to the next one. Okay, this is a GE Compactron filled set. And you can see it was laying on this side in the mud. And I think I have one of these that's in really good shape, but these things usually just work. I'll just plug it in and see what it does. I just plugged it in. The tubes are lighting up. Boy, we're rocking right here. Well, come on. You want to put on a display, do it now. There we go. Yeah, there we go. Talk about a thing of beauty. Look at this. Woo, baby. Talk about clean and shiny. Woo. Look at the rust. The tuner just had mud flowing through it. Jeez. It's a whole black and white TV. It's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9 tubes in it. Look at the dirt. Can't believe I'm actually checking this thing. Let it sit for a minute. Nah, I think the GE has seen better days. It's interesting what a tinker toy this set is. It's just got this little cheesy CRT, and then the knobs that stick out through the front, they're not even like real knobs, they're just adjustment pots, like you would see sticking through the back. Oh boy, a rejuvenation brought that right up. Look at that. Must have been dirty on the inside of the CRT also. Wow, that woke that right up. Look at this, we got really stout cutoff now too. Wow. That's impressive. This might be interesting to try and get this to work. I don't think it would take much, but it'd probably have to feed an IF signal straight into the board, because I don't think this tuner would ever function again, if you could even get it to turn. All right, here's the next mud-soaked orphan on the chopping block. It's a Panasonic. It's kind of an interesting layout, how it's indented back in there. No knobs. I don't know. Let's open her up. Okay, typical Panasonic. Look at that cute little flyback right there. Look at the dirt pouring out of it. Jeez. You know, my TV repair tools were not... Oh, the speaker's completely hollow. Look at that. This looks like some of those little Packard Bell sets, that all had the open vertical output transformer. Of course, there's no clue what CRT this is. All right, well, there are two adapters in here that fit on that thing. I have a 50% chance of getting it right. And this one is showing short right away and no emission, so let's try the other one. Okay, this is the other one. We're not getting a short. We're not getting any emission either. So one adapter shows short and no emissions, and the other adapter shows no short. Well, let me get the filament up here to 6 volts, like it's supposed to be. Oh, we're starting to see some emission here, okay. Boy, that thing is bright. Look at that. They really run that hot? If one must be good, two must be better, right? Look at that. I don't know. El Panasonico here seems to have woken up. Might be worth trying to get it to work. The board is awfully corroded. Okay, the next three are identical. They're the Taiwanese RCA ones. Okay, I think I have 4 of these now. Let's get one open and see what it looks like. Wow. Nasty. KCS-168XF. With built-in spider webs. Came up and now it's falling back down. What? What is up with these things? Clean this one off a little bit. There we go. Make an okay picture. It's not discolored much in there, so that's the first one. Okay, here's number 2. This is the one with the crack in the case. This one sure is a lot cleaner on the inside, except up here. And the CRT just came right up on its own. So this is a good candidate right here, except it's so trashed. Here's number 3. We got a sticker here. No dirt at the top. This one has the most elaborate of spider webs in it. Come on. I'm on Rejuvenate 1, which they say you can do it as many times as you want. So, say it doesn't hurt it, but I don't. All right, here's one I forgot. I'll tack this on the end. It's a little portable, about a 9-inch Toshiba black stripe. Nice and dirty and abused, and of course it works. The only problem is these knobs are broken. The fine-tuning knobs are all broken from the plastic being baked and brittle.
¿Qué tal? Los saluda la carnicería Julio Hernández desde su programa Cristo sana, salva y libera. Saludamos a los radioescuchas de Los Ángeles, de Ventura, de Riverside, de Orange, de Arcadia, de San Bernardino, en el 1500 AM, de Azusa, de Huescovina, de Covina, de Ontario, de Glendora, el Rancho Cucamonga, de Huntington Park, Montebello, Pico, Rivera, Santa Fe, Spring, La Jabra, Subway, Duarte, Santa Mónica, La Puente, Pomona, San Fernando, Monrovia, Corona, Baldwin Park, Alhambra, Anaheim y San Diego, en el 1400. Quieren ya.
Look at how good the convergence is on this. There is not one flaw in the convergence on this set. It is absolutely perfect.
El lugar Los Angeles Convention Center en el 1201 Sur Figueroa Street, Los Angeles, California, 90,015.
Here's looking at the back. We got our tint color brightnesses on the back. August 1980. What does it have four pins for? Is it 12 volt? Let's see, AC 120 volt, 60 watts. DC 12 volt, 24 watt. Oh, so you could use this in the car. You could watch porn in the car in this, and then you wouldn't have to solicit sexual favors.